There's a lot of advice on becoming a UX designer that it can get overwhelming when you're starting from scratch. You want to become a UX designer, but you don't know where to start, what tools to use, how to create a killer portfolio, where to connect with the right people, and also worried about AI. I'm here to simplify your journey into UX design step by step. So let me break down that for you. And no, becoming a UX designer, it's not only looking at Figma tutorials and mastering it. First, you need to learn the fundamentals. It's very important to solidify your basic knowledge. Start by learning how to figure out what users need. UX design is all about understanding people, like walking in their shoes. Learn to ask the right questions using interviews and surveys. Then dive into design thinking and solving problems. It's about spotting a problem, coming up with lots of ideas, and then making simple versions of these ideas to see if they work. Check out books like The Design of Everyday Things and Don't Make Me Think to learn about good design. Make your decisions easy and clear for everyone, including people with disabilities. Remember, grasp the concept of the aesthetic usability effect. People often find nice-looking designs easier to use. Next, focus on the fundamentals of visual design, like fonts, colors, and layouts. The goal is to make the user's experience better with these design elements. Also, learn about design systems. They are like guides that many companies use to make sure everything looks good and works well together. Essentially, a design system acts like a blueprint for both design and development, ensuring that there is consistency and efficiency across a product. The words you use in your designs, like on buttons and error messages, are really, really important. Clear writing helps users a lot. For example, consider the difference between a button labeled submit and other labeled send feedback. The latter is more descriptive and user-friendly, and helps improve the overall user interaction with the interface. Working well with others in UX design is key. You need to use feedback from your team and clients to make your designs better. Testing your designs with real users is super important. Their feedback helps you keep improving your designs. There's a lot of info out there on UX design. Even if you are on a budget, you can find great resources. Start with essential reads like Don't Make Me Think by Steve Krug and The Design of Everyday Things by Don Norman. These books provide fundamental insights into UX principles and are highly recommended in the field. Try the Google UX Design Certificate on Coursera. It's free and in-depth. Udemy has many UX courses that are budget-friendly. Look up the Nielsen Norman Group for expert articles. Smashing Magazine and Medium have lots of good articles and case studies, so you can also test it out. And this learning will help you decide if you want to go for more advanced courses or certifications. Got a topic in UX design you are curious about? Drop in the comments. I'd love to dive deeper into what interests you in my next videos. Now let's talk about tools. Tools are a big part of UX design. It's good to learn how to use some popular ones like Sketch, Adobe XD, and Figma. They help you create your designs and prototypes. I suggest picking one tool to start with and really get to know it. Figma, for example, is a favorite in many tech companies and a great place to begin. But remember that a design tool is just that, a tool. The tech world always changes and new tools keep coming up. When you're just starting in UX design, I think it's important to understand the basics and try out your own ideas. So focus on that. Focus on improving your design skills and using what you know. Don't worry too much about being perfect with one specific tool. As you practice and get better at UX design, you'll find it gets easier to use different tools. Networking is super important when you're looking for a job or growing your skills in UX design. It's a great way to learn new things and meet people who can help you. A good way to start is by chatting with experienced UX designers. You can find them on LinkedIn and even among your design friends. Why not ask them to grab a coffee or lunch? It's a nice and relaxed way to talk. These chats are really useful. You'll get a peek into what working in UX is and make connections that could help you find a job later on. But remember, networking isn't just for asking favors. It's also about sharing your ideas and learning from others. So be active in reaching out and talking to the people in the UX world. Creating a great portfolio is key to sharing your work and starting your UX career. Think of it as more than just showing off your designs. It's about telling the story of how you solve the problems in each project. Before you start making your own portfolio, look for inspiration from other designers you admire. If you already know what a good portfolio looks like, awesome. If you are new and not sure, here's a tip. Start by checking out the designers that you respect, especially those working at companies where you dream of working. You can find them on LinkedIn and see if they have shared their portfolios. When you look at these portfolios, don't just focus on the final designs. Pay attention to the whole process, the research, the early sketches, and how they overcome challenges. That's the stuff that really impresses people when they are hiring. Try to save about 10 to 15 portfolios that really speak to you. They can guide you when you're ready to build your own portfolio. And remember, your portfolio is like your story in the world of UX design. It shows not just what you've made, but how you think and grow as a designer. So, ready to create your portfolio? Why not begin with a design challenge? Look online for some cool ideas and try your hand at them. You can Google UX design challenges and you will find a list of them. But take a look into the video description where I list some of them. Think about redesigning an app you like, explain why you made certain design choices, spend some time thinking about which projects to start, and choose something that matches the kind of work you want to do in the future. Doing this shows off your skills and tells the world what you are passionate about in your career. So you've made a great portfolio and now it's time to find a job. Job hunting can take a lot of effort and time, but it's a big step towards your dream career. Start by checking job sites like LinkedIn and Indeed. They have lots of jobs listings. But don't just apply online and wait. A lot of people do that, especially for jobs at big companies. Stand out to get in touch with recruiters directly on these platforms. Look for recruiters from companies you want to work with. When you message them, be personal. Talk about jobs they're hiring for and how your portfolio matches what they are looking for. Show them you're not just another applicant. Be friendly and real in your messages. And try to connect with them by commenting on their posts, for example. This way, you're not just another resume. You're someone who takes the initiative and fits their company culture. It's a great way to get noticed and start your career in UX design. If you want some video about any topic that was discussed in this video, type here in the comments what topics you want to see in further videos. Now, let's tackle a big question. Will AI take over designers' job? It's a bit of a yes and no situation. AI won't fully replace designers. It's more about helping than replacing. It's getting involved in design work, but it can't do everything a design does. It doesn't have the same understanding of people and their needs, nor can it think deeply and creatively like a human. Think of AI as a helper that gives ideas. It can suggest design options, but it doesn't really get the whole story behind these ideas. That's where you, the designer, come in. You understand the reasons and thinking behind good design, something that AI isn't quite able to get yet. Use AI as a tool to make your work easier and to come up with new ideas. It's like having a smart assistant that helps you be more efficient. But remember, AI is there to support your skills in design thinking, creativity, and understanding people. So, AI isn't taking over. It's more like a teammate that helps you do your job better. The future of design is all about working together with AI to make more creative and cool stuff. Now, I want to share something really important. Be patient. Patience is your secret weapon to reach your dreams. Social media can make you feel like you need to rush to learn everything super fast and be the best instantly, but that's not how it works. Take it from me and many other designers out there. We've been doing this for more than 10 years. We know that success doesn't happen overnight. So don't worry if you're just starting out and things seem slow. Learning and growing at your own speed is the best way. The journey is not a race. Remember, the world is big and full of opportunities for everyone. You can find your own special place and people who love your work. Maybe you'll even start your own brand one day. So take a deep breath, don't rush. Learn at your own pace, a pace that is comfortable for you. Do it in your own way and you'll see how much you can achieve. And that's it. If you find this video useful, hit the like button, subscribe the channel to get more of this UX stuff, and comment with your feedback, ideas that could result in more videos for you. Thank you and have a great day.